Now I will turn into talk to more some practical problems to using BLAST. And one practical problem is actually you want to use is to use it's a low complexity. So there, it's known that in particular eukaryotic sequences contain what is called low complexity regions, so very, very repeated regions. There are, for instance, you can have collagen with a lot of G's and C's in it. So there are a lot of separations, and there are long stretches of the identical nucleotides, etc. And these are chemical problems because they are not following the assumption that sequences are randomly distributed, so they can cause high scoring false positives, for instance. So a reason for that is because 50% of genomic DNA in humans is repetitive. There are several reasons for it. The regional transposons, all regions, microsatellites, etc. And there are telomeric regions also. So for instance, you can have TCTCTCTC, so you have the things like that. And of course, any sequence that have these kind of regions will get very high score hits. But it must mean they're homologous. So how do we deal with this? So the answer, the question we want to ask is often when we do database search is to ask, is for an X homologous or not to a query sequence. So what you often do is you filter this out. So you have some method that you guys can filter out these low complex regions. This I already talked about before. Of course, homology doesn't mean that proteins are, it has to make sure that you look at alignment. So sequence A, sequence one contains two domains, A and B, and sequence two aligns well to one and has A, and sequence three aligns well to one and has but only B, domain B. It doesn't mean that sequence two and three are homologous. And make sure homology for multi-domain proteins and how to change domain contents is not really a well-defined question. So, but in general, you would say that if the domain content changes completely, you would not call this protein homologous.